everyone, welcome back to my channel. And today I wanted to do a bag collection video for you guys. I have been thinking about this and I don't think I am done collecting bags just yet. I still plan on getting an old Celine, but I haven't decided on which one I'm going to get. But I probably will get it from eBay from a Japanese seller, because then you'll know it's authentic. Anyway, I'm gonna start off with some of my random bags. This is my Manfrotto bag for my camera gear. I've got all of my lenses on here, and then on the top is where I keep the camera that I am filming on. I usually carry this when I am on my bike and I want to get some really good landscape shots. It's got straps on here for the tripod for me to be able to carry that, and it holds everything because I only own a mirrorless camera, so it's not a big DSLR. I'm done with huge ass DSLRs, so yeah, this is the one that I carry with me. Okay, now when I go to the gym, I've got a duffel bag from it's got stuck in my chair. Okay. I got a duffel bag from Adidas. Okay, so it's just got a pocket here on the side and two pockets inside. Now, this still has my gym stuff in it, so I'm not even gonna go into too much details on that. But this also came with a shoe bag that I used to put my trainers in. So there. It's also quite handy when I am doing or going on overnight trips or staying over at a friend's house and stuff like that. Next is my North Face backpack, which I often use for when I travel overseas as my hand carry, because this has got a laptop compartment in there, and I always bring my laptop with me when I travel. Just because, especially when I'm going to be away for quite a while, like more than a week, then I definitely will. It's got loads of compartments. That's it. I got this in Vietnam. Normally, this would cost upwards of $150. But because this was from the Benton Market in... not Benton Market. I forgot which... It's in the old quarter in Hanoi, not in Ho Chi Minh, in Hanoi. This was something like $35. I think they make it in Vietnam, and these are like factory overruns, so not the real deal. I still think it's real. It's done in the same factories. It's just it didn't pass their quality control, and I don't know what about it didn't pass the quality control, because it looks pristine. It even has that flex vent at the back so that you don't get sweaty when you are using it. Okay, the next random bag before I go into my branded bags is this straw bag. It's a crossbody straw bag that was gifted to me by my siblings, I think back in 2016, I don't even remember when. But yeah, this is made in the Philippines. Made in my country, yep. Nothing special about it. It's just a magnetic clasp. And that's it. So summer is fast approaching here in Australia. It's definitely gonna get some use. Alright, so let me start off with the ones that I am not confident are authentic, okay? This one in particular I know is not, because the seller actually told me that it isn't. But it's so darn pretty that I don't think I really care that much. Okay, this is supposed to be the Louis Vuitton Monogram Alma MM, I think is what it's called. And this is the one that came with like the studs. Okay, there is a version of the Alma that do not have the studs. And how can you tell that it is real? Well, first of all, the bottom. Okay, the real ones have this same material at the bottom and not this, so I can already tell. And the inside of the real Alma is red. Although this is still a very, very good leather. Inside is suede. The outside is treated leather. And if you are not in the know, you wouldn't know that this was not a real Louis Vuitton. I think I paid $85 for this, but it's okay. Everything else is beautiful. I still want to keep it, even though I actually have this on my eBay and my Depop, but I'm actually thinking of removing this from there and then just keeping this, even though I know that this isn't authentic. Okay. The next one that I have is by Prada. Now this I am not sure because I got this from a secondhand shop, Cardigan Corner in Newtown. By the way, this is from Recycled Rags in Neutral Bay. Okay, she's a it's a consignment store. This one is from a thrift shop called Cardigan Corner in Newtown. And everything about it screams that it's real, with the exception that it has a zipper. The other ones that I've seen that are exactly like this have two magnets as closure instead of a zip. But I have also found some, a different model, that have zips on it. So, and everything about this bag is telling me that it's authentic. From the quality of the leather, the Prada triangle over there. I actually noticed that one of the bags that I was looking at, which isn't exactly this model, also had the same stitching on the zips. So also has this little, I don't know what this is. And in the inside, it has the correct lining. It says Prada Milano, and when it's made. And it also has the tag that says Prada. Now Prada doesn't have serial numbers on their bags, which is what makes it hard to distinguish whether it's fake or not. But everything about this bag, with the exception of the closure, which is a zip, tells me that this is authentic. I would like to believe that it is, but even if it wasn't, I bought this for like $35. Not bad. Okay, the next one is here. This is a Michael Kors straw bag. It looks quite tattered. It looks like it's been through quite a lot, but because it's coming to summer, I thought this would be a good addition to my collection. I got this from the same shop that I got the Prada bag from, which is Cardigan Corner in Newtown. Now this looks authentic, and I think that it is. I just don't know what year it's from. The craftsmanship is beautiful. Everything about it tells me that it is the real Michael Kors bag. Mm-hmm. So the lining says MK and all that. It doesn't have any tags inside, aside from here where it says Michael Kors. Yeah, and this looks like really old, like 90s kind of bag. So I would like to believe that it is authentic. All right, now let's start with the first ever, for sure, authentic bag that I got. And this was gifted to me by my sister back in 2013 as a birthday present, and this is by Coach. She got it from the factory store in the US, so, and she even told me shipping to Australia was more expensive than the bag itself, because I think when you go to the Coach outlets in the States, this is so old that it's already like fraying in the handles. I don't know if you can see that, but yeah, really pretty. I have quite a few stuff in there, yeah, and it's all like dirty, but it's okay. That's expected for a, 6-year-old bag. It has obviously the serial number, and like I said, it was bought from the factory outlets in Illinois. There we go. So that's number one. The next bag that I got, that is that I know is authentic. Where is it? Is it this one? Here. This isn't the right dust bag for it. It says Calvin Klein. The dust bag actually belongs to my backpack. But this one is a Coach tote that I got from the outlets here in Australia at DFO Homebush. So, I really like the color of this. This is an oxblood tote that is the reversible kind. So you can see here, that's the inside, and you can just flip it inside out and it would work as both. So it's got the Coach emblem on there and also on the inside. Now I've got a little pillow in here so that it keeps its shape. And this also came with a pochette, well, or a pouch. and on the pouch is where the serial number is. Okay, it's got this little like keychain. I don't know. And this is where the bag actually, or the pouch actually is connected. So I'm gonna put that back on because I'm not gonna be using the pouch as my makeup bag anymore because that's what I use it for. And I'm like, that's too fancy for a makeup bag. Anyway, put that, bringing that back in. I try to keep my bags in dust bags whenever I can. Like, if I'm not using them, they're gonna be in a dust bag. As long as I have a dust bag that is that size. Okay. Oh. That wasn't the next one. Actually, it's here. Again, not the dust. There's a dust bag for this. It says 9 West, but in here is a Kate Spade bag. Again, from my sister. She's, did I get this 2015 or 2016? I don't remember. It was Christmas and we all were back in the Philippines. Maybe 2016. No, December 2016 I was in Scotland. So it might have been 2017? No, 2017 I was here. I don't remember. But anyway, Kate Spade from the factory outlets in Illinois as well. You can see the Kate Spade lining there. It's got this big compartment in there. And then this would actually be able to fit like an iPad or something like that. I've got some stuff in here in the pockets, like business cards and all. Huh. And an old headphone. Okay. Right. So yeah, so that's what's inside. There's another big pocket in there and two small pockets on the side. It can be held like that or with a strap. I actually managed to, there's a little bit of like rubbing of like dark jeans on here, which is why I'm not a fan of light colored bags because they tend to get rubbed off. Okay, I actually need to put stuffing in here so that it doesn't lose its shape, but otherwise really, really good, really beautiful bag. Okay, I'll return them to their dust bags afterwards. So that was actually my second designer bag. Then what came next? Ah, I bought these two at the same time. So this is my Calvin Klein backpack. Beautiful leather, soft. It's pebbled leather with silver hardware. And I use this to work. When I used to go to a workplace and not work from home, this was my bag of choice because it's just easier to have it like slung around your shoulders as opposed to having a shoulder bag that weighs down one side of you. So I had this. Just two little pockets here and a big pocket at the back. Do I have anything in that pocket? Well, I actually have quite a few things in that pocket. some paperwork. So this from Calvin Klein. I think I got it for $120 at the DFO Homebush. And then on the same day, I happened to go to the Armani outlet there, and they were having a 50% off sale. And then on top of that 50% off sale, they had 40% off as well. So I got this beautiful bag. And what I loved about it is that it's tri-color, so it doesn't matter what kind of leather shoes I wore, it would still be appropriate for it. So I haven't even removed that little silicone cover for the zip. What I just don't like how you could actually unclasp this and then you'd have better access to what's inside. There's one pocket with a zip and two little pockets, and had like this tag on here that would tell you like how to take care of it, where it's made, blah 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 blah. So but yeah, this can be buttoned or clasped on there on the side, but when I do that it makes it harder to get to the zip. This also would need some stuffing, so I already asked my husband to bring home some old newspaper from work. And it can be held as a like a handheld bag, or it also comes with a black strap, which it has got like a mild gold tone, and it says AJ or Armani jeans on it. There we go. I could probably use this strap for my other bags, or I could also take off the ones here in the Kate Spade one. If I had a black bag that I wanted to put a strap on. In fact, I do have a bag that I want to put a strap on, but I will show you that in a little bit. After that, I went to my first Sydney suitcase rummage and I found this. I got it for $100 off a stall holder. It's by Tory Burch. And I just love the color of this bag. It's a satchel bag with a gold hardware, two handles, and also a long strap. Okay, and then, well, I've got some tissue in there, so that's the inside. And what I found cute about this is that it actually came with a mirror. Not that I ever used it, because it's all smudgy. So anyway, beautiful, beautiful bag. Love the mustard yellow color. I was actually bidding on a Louis V, however you want to call that, puzzle bag that was tan, but I lost out because it in the last like 1 minute, people started like bidding, and I was bid by over $100. So I'm like, oh fudge. Anyway. Beautiful bag. That's my Tory Burch bag, my first Tory Burch bag, because I did find a second one. And this one is also so cute. This is from U-Turn Vintage. I paid $39 for it. It's a white little bag, so tiny. Fits my iPhone 11, but anything bigger than that, it won't close. And this is with a metal closure. Long, so if I just want to bring my cards and my phone, and especially during the summer where it doesn't really rain here, it's gonna be perfect. So when you open that up, it's got like Tory Burch on there, some card slots, and then like I said, it could fit my wallet and my phone, or my card wallet or card holder and my phone, which is enough. That's all. I don't keep this in a dust bag because I carry this quite a lot. So there's no point in like putting it in and out. The next thing, here. I got this from another U-Turn Vintage. This one is from a U-Turn Vintage in Surrey Hills. Surrey Hills. And this is a Gucci, I think it's called a Shelby bag. So it's got that very well-known Gucci strap, has the zips, and I know that this is authentic, and I've got my stuff in there, because where it says Gucci over there, it also has the serial number, which I googled, and it came up with this bag. Yep. The only thing...
Just a moment. You can find that information in settings.
Oh, Siri is talking to me, even though I'm not talking to him. The only thing is, it was broken. Like, if you can see the zip. Yeah, there you go. That's broken. That's the only thing that's wrong with it. So I didn't really mind. I was thinking about, like, getting it relined and have the zipper replaced, but I'm like, doesn't really matter to me. So, yep. Gucci. Got that. Next thing that I got, I bought from eBay, and this is a Burberry Blue Label bag. So you can see there it says Burberry Blue Label, and on the inside it also says Burberry Blue Label. For those of you who are not familiar with the Blue Label line of Burberry, they are exclusively made and distributed in Japan. Up until 2016, a company called Sanyo Shokai was actually licensed to create the Burberry brand in Japan to cater to the younger, more modern generation. And they had a line of clothing and accessories that were of a smaller size to fit the Asian market. But in 2015, Burberry decided that they were going to enter the market as Burberry. So they've stopped renewing the license of Sanyo Shokai, so they couldn't do the Burberry Blue Label or Black Label anymore. Now the Blue Label and Black Label are now under I think it's called Blue Label Crestbridge. Oops, I think I've got a delivery. Hold on. Okay, so where was I before I was rudely interrupted by our wine delivery? I don't drink wine. It's all for my husband. Anyway, Blue Label. So yeah, in 2015, Burberry decided that they were going to enter the Japanese market as Burberry. So now Blue Label comes under the brand Blue Label Crestbridge, I believe it is. They still make similar patterns, but they are no longer licensed to use the Burberry name. Okay, I got this from eBay. Paid $135 for this. It smells really good. And I did check the authenticity from the serial in the tag in here, and it's legit. It is legit. Okay. And then the last one, which I only got this weekend, is probably one of the best things that I have found at the weekend markets here in Australia. I went to the Kirribilli market at Milsons Point over the weekend and found this beautiful, I believe this is called the Empriente. Anyway, here we go. This is the Louis Vuitton monogram black Empriente leather métisse, I think is what it's called. I got it for $200, which is quite cheap. Because this sells for a lot more than that. And I am pretty sure that it is legit. First of all, the material, the leather is really, really good. The hardware is exactly as what it is on all of the websites that I have seen this product on. The only thing is, and I think this is why it was sold like that, is that this clasp here, this one on the side doesn't function as well, so you need to actually, when you click on that, you need to lift it with your finger because otherwise it won't let go. But beautifully made. That's that there. The inside, I've got a pillow in there as well. So that's what the inside looks like. It says that it is Louis Vuitton Paris, made in Spain. And then when I let me get the freaking pillow out. And then inside of the pocket is a serial number, or like the date code. It's a CA0144. And you can see this little tag here. And when I checked, it was made in Spain in 2014 of January. Because when you're reading the Louis Vuitton code, the first two letters represent which factory they're made from, and there is a list of where those factories are. So CA is actually in Spain. And then 0144, the first and third digits, so 04, represents the week of the year that it was made. So that's in January. Week 4 of the year is in January. And then the second and fourth digits, which is in this case 1 and 4, represents the last two numbers of the year, so 2014. So January 2014. On the handle, it has Louis Vuitton Paris on it. And same with the strap right here. It's hard to tell with the strap. I think it's been like rubbed off for quite a while, but at a certain angle you can definitely see it. That's why I'm confident that this $200 bag is a real Louis Vuitton from the market. The seller was actually selling it for a friend, so I'm not even sure that she knew that she was selling the real Louis Vuitton, because why would you sell it for $200 anyway? And even if it wasn't real, the quality of this is so good that there is no way you would think that it isn't real. Anyway, yeah. So that is my handbag collection, or those are my bag collections. I've got a lot of them, as you can tell. But yeah, the other ones that I am selling is going to be linked on my Depop and in my eBay, which is going to be in the description bar down below. Those aren't real. I already know they aren't real. So I'm just letting you guys know in case you were interested in any of them. But yeah, and that's pretty much it. I am thinking of getting a Celine bag, and I'm going to put in the pictures of my two choices right here. And let me know which one you think I should get. I am looking for a small black bag, or navy, because the other option is navy. And let me know which one you think I should get. The black one, I am very interested because I do like the embossed logo in the front, and the buttons on the strap. The navy one, I like the structure, and the gold hardware. So yeah, let me know. Thank you for joining me in this long-ass video. If you have any questions or comments, maybe you want to know what I look for or how I look for these bags when I go thrifting, let me know in the comments down below. If you have any questions about thrifting or secondhand shopping in Sydney, let me know. Okay, and I will see you all again in my next video. Bye!